he's not here. Which means that we just have to keep looking for him.
What we have to do is just slow down for a minute, Reva. We've just spent the entire day answering questions about Alfred's death. We need to calm down for just a minute, and then we'll...
What's going on?
Oh, my God, I've been so worried about you.
Alfred, his body, did you find it, Reva? He swims like a fish. What if he's still alive?
He's not. Believe me, he's not.
No, you don't understand. He could still be out
there. He's not. Trust me. You need to calm down.
Knowing he's dead and thinking he's dead are two different things.
We know for sure that Alfred is dead, Jonathan. You were right. He survived the first fall into the water. After that, I killed him.
If you could, please just page my grandmother one more time. I know she's here. I just need some money.
Lizzie? You didn't hear that.
Hi. I'm fine. I'm good. It's just money and, I don't know, it'll be over soon. What about you? I heard that Jonathan's dad kidnapped you. Some crazy story. True story. That's awful.
Well, we can talk about it someday, just not today.
Was Jonathan involved?
Jonathan saved me, okay? He took on his own father, the man who's beaten him down his whole life. He faced his worst fears for me, okay? And I've never seen anything so brave. I owe him so much.
You really care about him?
Well, don't. Okay, it's been said a zillion times before. Stay away from Jonathan because he's no good. I don't need to hear it from you.
I wasn't gonna say that. I was just gonna say that, you know, he's done a lot for you. You can't just bail out on him now.
All the trouble to track the plate numbers to that particular car agency, only to be told, sorry, we don't give out that information. A waste of time. We walked out of there completely empty-handed.
The hell we did. We know he knows something.
Did you snap out of it? We are no closer to figuring out whether Philip is here and alive than we were, I don't know, 24 hours ago, 48 hours ago. What are you doing?
I'm sitting back and enjoying the show. Go on, don't let me stop you.
Well, I'm so glad you're having such a wonderful time.
You're so angry right now, but I give it about 7 seconds, and it'll completely change your mind.
What am I doing here on this wild Philip Chase with you when I could be home getting ready to marry the man that I love?
It's got to be a new record, 3 seconds. Listen, if that's what you want to do, why don't you call Gus, and why don't you tell him that you're on your way home now?
Oh, I will.
Okay, do it then. Here you go.
Watch me.
Oh, I'm watching. Go on. Uh-huh. You dialing?
Look, what is the point, right? I can't tell him what he wants to hear anyway.
You mean because it would be a complete waste of time, which is something I've been trying to tell you.
Don't!
It's a waste of time if we're down here.
I don't need you to say I told you so, okay? Maybe this isn't where I should be right now, okay? Maybe it's not, but it's where I need to be.
What's this? Where is everybody? Where are the lights on?
Surprise!
What are you doing?
What are you thinking of?
Well, it's a bachelor party.
Hey, yeah. So far, it's going pretty great, except I have nothing to compare it to. It's my first one.
Yeah, well, I'm honored. You seem like we're having a good time.
Yeah, we started without you, buddy.
Hey, music, I'm loud and happy, okay? All right.
One more night of freedom.
It's a bachelor party. Up!
Hey, Gus, here, take a beer, man.
Thank you, yeah. Thank you very much.
Hey, come on, here, to Gus, right?
To Gus! Very much.
Can I give you some advice? Yes. Tell Jonathan how you feel. Let him know that he's got a good friend.
Why?
It hurts when nobody wants you around. And everybody just kind of sits around waiting for you to make your next big mistake. After a while, it's Why don't you just give them what they want? But, you know, I mean, things have changed for me. I don't feel so doomed anymore. What made you change? Someone believes in me. All it takes is one person. The right person. You understand what I'm saying? Yeah, I think I do. And you know something? I believe that you will pay me back. You and Roxy, I mean. If I loan you, say, all I've got is a 10. We'll take it.
He was trying to kill Reva. He would have killed her. He would have killed me. He went in, and that was it. I'm sorry.
Sounds like the bastard finally got what he deserves. He was rotten right up to the end. Good guys win. It's like a summer blockbuster. 5 stars.
Jonathan, it's shock.
Shock?
Yes.
No, I'm happy. This is me. Happy. You haven't seen it in such a long time. Maybe you're in shock.
Losing the people who brought you up. I mean, both of them. In a couple of weeks is a very hard thing.
No, I've been through a lot harder, trust me. I feel like the sun is shining, the world's biggest boa constrictor just got lifted off my neck, and I am breathing free at last. Hallelujah! I am free!
Bottles up to Gus, come on.
His
first walk down the aisle.
To marriage. You know, it's a beautiful word, a fine institution, so say goodbye to your free weekends and hello to your honey bottomless to-do list, so.
Yeah, there you go.
Right?
Welcome to the world of marriage, Gus, where men are born, we're wrong, and then we die.
To the world of feelings, Gus, her feelings, your feelings, and her feelings, and how you feel about her feelings.
Hey, Rick, let's not talk about the problem.
Take it easy.
And here's to the wardrobe you never knew your wife had. Sweatpants from high school and a bunch of baggy t-shirts. I'm not!
So, what do you say then, Gus?
Yeah, bring it. Bring it on.
Yeah,
I'll go down in flames.
Life is over.
I keep telling myself, I can't walk away until I know for sure if Philip is alive, you know, because I have to tie up all those loose ends before I move on to the next part of my life. Because that's who I am, right? That's who I've always been, right?
That's right. I can vouch for that.
Maybe there's more to it than that. You know, maybe there's something else.
Okay, so why don't I give you a hand? Why don't I help you out?
Well, I am not sure that I have the answer.
Why are you here?
I'm here to find out if Philip's alive.
Here, with me, here, in a place that looks exactly the same as the day you left. Because this place used to mean something to us. Right? Used to mean something to you back then?
Yes, it did.
So what about now?
Well, when I, when I walked in here at first, I was curious. Because, I was expecting that I would hate being here again.
And you don't?
No. We had so much hope when we started out.
We were happy here, very happy here.
What happened?
We were young and I was stupid.
I can't marry Gus.
Why?
Because I have to figure out why it
it happened the way it happened, why it keeps happening that way. You know, I blamed you. But the truth is, maybe it's me. I've blown how many marriages? How many times? And you were all different, but I was the same. I was the single consistent factor, and I have to look at that. You know, they say some women, they're just not meant to be married. Well, maybe that's me. Maybe I shouldn't be married. Or maybe there's just something really, really, really wrong with me.
I think there's no question about that.
Jonathan, wait! Do me a favor. Just stay here, please, for a few days, so that I know you're not alone.
Why?
Because I almost lost you? Because the honest truth is that I will sleep a whole lot better if I know I can keep an eye on you. Just for a few days. Josh thinks it's a good idea too, don't you?
I don't know. I don't know whether either one of you should be alone tonight. I know I need to be alone tonight.
It could sound like you're going somewhere.
You're not staying?
I think it's the best thing for both of us. Don't break anything.
No promises.
I'll call you in the morning.
Joshua. Please. Don't leave.
Reba, don't make this any tougher than it already is, okay?
Please.
What are you doing here?
There's something that I haven't been able to say to you. Something that I need you to know.
Okay. Shoot.
What you did for me, JB, I'll never forget it.
I already have.
Well, I won't. And whatever's happened between us, whatever is going to happen between us, I will always remember and think of you as a friend.
Screw that.
What?
He's dead. I'm free. I'm gonna get what I want. I don't want to be your friend.
Come on,
turn out the juice. He's right. Let in some oxygen.
Yes. All right.
What does he know about marriage?
Finish this beer off. Anybody who's with me, say, oi!
Oi! Oi!
Hey, Gus.
Funny.
Gus, come here. There's something left for you on the porch there.
Frank. Oh. Who's that from?
Not sure.
No name? Doesn't say?
Uh-oh. Any ex-girlfriends that might be a little ticked off that they're losing you?
Yeah, speaking of ticking, you might want to put your ear to that and make sure that it's not.
No, oh, Frank, come on.
You think there's something wrong with me?
Oh, I just don't think I know. You want to hear what's wrong with you?
No.
Too bad, because here it goes. You're going to get it anyway. You haven't changed.
No, you still run around looking for problems when there aren't any to find. And listen to me. And just because you've been doing that for years doesn't make it okay. So why don't you look at yourself and look at your life for how they really are? I mean, why don't you believe for a change?
Believe?
Yeah, believe in your feelings. Believe in yourself. Believe in the choices you made, the choices you will make. You know, the same instincts that were great for you as a cop, they can help you out now, too.
Maybe I am listening to my instincts. And maybe they're scaring me. What if I need to know for sure?
Well, sometimes you don't know for sure. And if I would have known for sure, that means that you and I would still be Look, maybe you are running. Maybe this whole hunt for Philip thing is just an excuse so you don't have to walk down the aisle again.
Maybe it is.
But agreeing to come here, of all places, and agreeing to come here with me, of all people? Well, maybe it's just an excuse.
Maybe it is an excuse. I don't know.
Well, I do know. I do know. I know that I don't want it to be an excuse for you. And more than that, I don't want you to have any excuses, okay? So I know what I have to do.
I love Gus. I love Gus, and I'm gonna marry him. And I won't change my mind about that. Not now, not ever. I love him.
Well, you see.
See what?
That kiss that I just gave you, I mean, that wasn't maybe the world's greatest kiss, but it was more than a weak in the knees moment. I mean, I don't know if it was a fall to the floor, grade A, Megamax smoocheroo, but it was a pretty good kiss, and, you know, you did two things. You pushed me away, and you told me that you loved another man.
Sorry.
Don't be. Can you do me one last favor? Can you, get out of here and fly back home? And, you know, decide on your wedding day hairdo.
I don't want to fail again. I don't want to do it again, for Gus or for me.
You are not the reason that you and I didn't make it. I am. I blew it. And I know exactly when it happened.
You do?
Yeah. I was sleeping one night and I was watching you. You were beautiful. And it just hit me.
What?
I had this moment when I realized I was looking at you sleeping. And I just realized how much I needed you. And how much I loved you. I got scared, and I ran like a little, I ran like a frightened rabbit.
So, you cheated on me because I was great?
Easy, honey, I didn't say all that.
No, listen, you were terrific. So stop second-guessing yourself, okay? And stop trying to push Arturo away. Look, I mean, I'm not crazy about the guy, okay? But, hey, maybe because he's not me. You can trust him.
How do you know?
Because he's not me. He's not gonna let you down the way I did.
What is it, Gus? What's wrong?
Well, maybe it's tonight's entertainment.
Hey!
I don't know. The stripper didn't show up.
Maybe she sent
the tape. I don't know.
Yeah. Wonder if Blake
set this bad boy up.
Thought crossed my mind.
All right, now. Let's see what we got.
You're the pipeline of antimonies to the mob.
Gus, you don't know what you're talking about.
Gus, that's
you and Alexander explaining this to Alan.
What was that? I mean, what's going on here?
That's a
tape that surfaced right before the wedding last year, so.
That's the reason why we didn't have a wedding.
Really?
It's a long story.
So this is someone's idea of a bad joke? So who's the one with the lousy sense of humor?
Hey, Gus, take it easy, okay? I'll find out who was behind this.
I know who's behind it, Frank. My father.
Well, Alan doesn't give up, does he, even from a padded cell?
It's unbelievable. Unbelievable.
Well, listen, guys, I gotta go. I'll possibly get a call.
Yeah. All right.
Guys, let's give Gus some space, huh?
Gus, just take it easy, all right?
Yeah.
So what's your gut tell you? Is this wedding gonna happen? Or does it feel like it did the last time you almost got married?
Yeah, this wedding's gonna happen. The way it's supposed to. No matter what anybody thinks, especially my father. I know your daughter. And she'll be here. She'll be here.
Hey, sweetheart.
I'm fine.
Lizzie, what's wrong, honey?
I'm fine.
No, you're not fine. What's going on?
Just, I need to catch my breath.
Okay,
it's all right.
What's going on? Do you have a headache or a dizzy spells? Nosebleed? What is it?
I don't want Roxy to see me like this. She's too high strung.
What is it, honey? Just take your time. Take a deep, deep, slow breath. You're trying too hard. Okay, right from the bottom of your tummy, okay? Good. All right, now, talk to me. When did this start?
A couple days ago.
Okay, same symptoms, trouble breathing?
A headache.
Okay. Where did this happen?
The first time I was trying to get money from an ATM, and then, the second, I was trying to pump gas, and all of a sudden my hands started shaking and they were sweaty. I'm not gonna die, am I?
You're not gonna die.
Do I need to get tests done, like run blood, or what do you need to do?
Lizzie, I think I know what's going on here. Your mother told me that she cut you off.
Oh.
I think you're a classic example, honey, of acute panic brought on by pneumonitis, and you got it really, really bad.
God, I'm ridiculous.
No, you're just a girl who can't say, may I charge it, please? And that's big for you.
Is this terrible that I'm freaking out because my mom cut off my credit cards?
No. Give me your hands.
Why?
Because I asked for them, both of them. Give them to me.
I'm going to get a lecture.
No, you're not going to get a lecture. This is a story. Now, do you remember that we were here not too long ago, that you were in this hospital?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Do you remember that I was with your father that night? I was sitting right on this bench right here, and you were in ICU.
Daddy was worried about me.
Yes, he was. But, sweetheart, he was more worried about himself and your mother. Because your father knew that you were stronger than anybody else in the entire family. He said those words, Lizzie is the strong one.
He really said that?
Yes, he did. So now's your chance, honey, to prove that your father was right.
Friendship's all I can give you. I can't...
Stop. Please. What, do you think I wanted more than friendship? Is that it? Because you're wrong. I was looking for less.
What?
You have done nothing but make a mess of my life since the first day I met you. It's because you don't mind your own business. If you weren't involved in this, I'd be gone right now. The old man would probably still be alive.
You don't mean that.
All you do is make trouble for me. It is not worth it. It costs too damn much to care about you. I realize that now. I'm done with it.
Stop it. Why are you doing this?
What, telling the truth?
But it isn't. Your life is your own, like you said. Nate can't hurt you. He's gone. And I thought since things are different now, maybe we could start over.
Yeah? You thought wrong. You'll get over it.
Why are you doing this? You don't have to.
You're right. Everything I've done to you in the past, you thought Alfred was behind it all, but he's not in control anymore. I am. This is me. Me. Nobody else. So I'm gonna say this loud and clear once more so you get the message, Tammy. All right? Now listen up. You stay the hell away from me. You got it?
No.
We're in serious trouble here. I mean, this distance between us, it can't go on, not like this.
I know that.
So we need to find a common ground so that we can work on it.
I just don't know that I can do that right now, okay? This marriage is very important to me, Reva, obviously, but after what happened, I killed a man. I have to figure out how I'm gonna live with that.
You didn't have any choice. You were protecting me. That's
why. I hated the man. That's why I did it, Reva. Yeah, I was trying to protect you. But the fact that you wanted him, the fact that somehow he got to you, that was plenty for me.
You're a good man.
I'm an angry man. If I wasn't so angry, maybe I wouldn't have done what I did.
But I know why you did it. Don't punish yourself. If you're looking for answers, then look at me, please. Ask me. After everything that's happened, Jonathan's not the only one who should be alone tonight. Please stay with me.
I don't know, Rima. I just don't know.
I do. There's one thing we've learned after all the years we've spent together. All the ups and the downs. We hang on hardest whenever it's hardest to hang on. It's the right thing to do.
Maybe.
And stay. Stay and see. Just for a couple of nights. Bud, please, what do you say?
It's never been easy for me to say no to you.
Yeah, well, it's my secret weapon. That and loving you so much and knowing in my bones that whatever we had, we can put back together.
I wish I had your confidence.
Hey. Uncle Josh.
You're the best surprise I've had all day. You gonna stay for dinner?
No, you can't. You're leaving. Tammy's leaving.
Actually, dinner sounds great. Thank you. I'd love to stay.
Well, I hope everyone's had enough to eat.
I really wasn't hungry. I had a big lunch.
Okay, look. The only way we're gonna get our lives back to normal is by living a normal life.
Don't push it, Reva.
Yeah, don't push it. Thanks for the food and the offer to crash, but I'm gonna get out of here.
Where are you gonna go? This is home. This is where you belong. Would you argue with him, please? I'm gonna go up and I'm gonna get your old room ready for you. I'll be back in a minute.
So, you guys gonna fight me about this or what?
Let's not turn this into a heavyweight bout, all right? Stay, for your mom's sake.
Whatever you say, boss. I need some air.
You okay, Tammy?
I'm not sure. There's so much I don't understand.
About?
People.
Yeah, people. Let me tell you something about people like Jonathan, who carry around so much excess baggage with them all the time. They really love it when somebody else carries that baggage for them. You have a good life, Tammy. Sandy's a good guy. Do what's best for you.
We always do. Mostly. Night, Uncle Josh.
Night, sweetheart.
know you want me to leave you alone, but there's something else I need to say.
Go ahead, just make it fast.
Remember one time I told you I wish I'd never met you?
Uh-huh.
It isn't true.
Hey, there he is.
Okay, what's wrong? What's going on?
Did you call him?
I did. I need a second opinion. Dr. Bradshaw, I think, could solve some of your problems.
What problems?
We need to confer. Okay. Excuse us just a second, please. Mrs. Spalding is suffering from several symptoms, some of which you may recognize yourself, doctor. For example, first and foremost, her hands start to shake when she starts to do a task. That somebody else can do for her.
Right.
Secondly, credit card cancellation.
Never good.
It's scary. You take charge of this case, I would be very grateful.
Oh, this is my day off.
A woman without a credit card is scary for me, doctor. Please, would you do this for me?
All right.
Thank you.
I'll do my best.
Very good. All right, kids. Good luck.
Thanks, Uncle Ray.
All right.
So?
Dr. Bradshaw, huh?
That's me. That's right. Miss Spalding. Today is your lucky day. The doctor just happens to be you.
We're closed.
Lights are on.
Yeah, I was just about to shut them off.
Why don't I help you with that?
Hey.
You're Gus Ituro, right? I'm here for your party.
Yeah, I was told the stripper was canceled.
Well, I never got that call. Lucky you.
Yeah, lucky me.
Of course, I could leave if you wanted me to.
No, stay. I'm thinking you're exactly what I need right about now.
Things in life are absolutely free. Got it?
The best things in life are free.
I need a sign to let me know you're here. All of these lines are being crossed over the atmosphere.
Spalding is still alive?
Where?
He's still in Springfield right now? Now?
No, hey, listen, man. Maybe is good enough. That's good enough for me right now. Thanks, man. Later.